Hello everybody and welcome to Casablanca's virtual gymnastics competition. This is open to all Casablanca gymnasts, whether you attend a preschool gymnastics class right through to our teen gymnastics classes. This video will explain the elements that you need to include in a routine to send in to be reviewed by one of our qualified judges. Here are the things your routine should include. A balance on one leg. Here are some of our coaching team demonstrating some different balances you could do, but you're welcome to try any kind of balance you like as long as it's on one leg. The second thing you need to include is a balance that's low to the ground. Here's our coaching team again, who are demonstrating some examples of some things you could do, but you're welcome to come up with your own balance that's low to the ground. The next thing you need to include in your competition routine video is a demonstration of flexibility. Again, here are some of our coaching team showing you some examples of what you could do if you wanted to, although of course you're welcome to choose something completely different of your own. The final thing you need to include in your routine is a jump or a leap. Here's some of our coaches demonstrating some of the jumps that you could do, but again, you're welcome to choose anything of your own. Just to recap, your routine should include four skills: a 1 foot balance, a balance low to the ground, a demonstration of flexibility, and a jump or a leap. Once you've filmed your routine video, you need to email it to us at info@casablancacgt.co.uk. In your email, you should include three pieces of information: your name, your age, and the class that you come to, for example, Tuesdays at 6 o'clock. One of our qualified judges will watch your video and will email you back with some written feedback with things that you did really well and things that you can improve on and practice at home. Our virtual competition will be running until the end of this month, although once we receive your video, we aim to get back to you within 1 or 2 days. We look forward to seeing your entries. Make sure when you're practicing at home that you do so safely. It's important to warm up before you begin. Keep watching for an example of a warm-up that you can do at home. Also, make sure you've got plenty of room around you and you're not going to bump into anything. You're welcome to do your own warm-up, but here's an example of one that you can do at home if you wanted to. There's a pulse raiser activity first, followed by some stretching. Please note that these videos are filmed before the social distancing measures came into place.
questions now. So stand nice and clean, keep your arms by the sides. And up to the ceiling. Down to the floor. Over to the right. And the left. Ear to your right shoulder. Ear to your left shoulder. Good, rolling your shoulders backwards. Make sure you're still standing, 2 feet together. And stepping forwards. Good, swinging your arms forwards and backwards. And arms up and down. And circling your arms backwards. When you do this, you're trying to keep your arms really straight, stretching your fingers, again, keeping your feet together. And forwards. Bring nice straight arms, stretch fingers. And if you can try one arm going forwards, one arm going backwards. And if you're really clever, you can do the other arm forwards and the other arm backwards. Good, so okay, give the wrist a shake. And bending, stretching your fingers. And circling your wrists. And then the other way. Good, one arm out in front. Hold onto your elbow, put it across your body. Each of these stretches you want to hold for about 10 seconds each. And the other arm out in front, hold onto your elbow, put it towards your body. Try and keep your hips facing forward when you do this one. Don't turn the whole body, just your arm. And one arm straight, bend your elbow, hold your elbow, push it down gently. Try not to be like this. Leaning forward, trying to keep your head up. And other arm up nice and straight. Bend your elbow, hold your elbow, and push down. Again, trying to keep your head up. Okay, feet apart now, hands on your hips. Nice big circles, round and round, really big movements. And round the other way. One arm up really tall, right next to your ear, other hand on the hip, and reaching over the side. When you do this, you want to keep your body in a straight line. So you want to make sure you're not leaning forwards, you're not leaning backwards, everything's nice and straight. And other arm up really tall. We always want to have nice straight arms, stretched fingers, and over to the sides. And both arms out here, twisting side to side. You'll be looking right round with your head, so you're really twisting as far as you can. Good, okay, hands on your hips, and bending and straightening. Try and keep your back nice and straight when you do this one. And up and down on your toes. Feet a little bit wider apart, and now you're going to be bending from side to side. You want to make sure that your knee never goes over your toe. You always want to have your foot the furthest thing away. And then arms stretched out to the side, really nice straight arms, stretch fingers, opposite hands, opposite foot. Good. Now take feet together now, stretching up really tall. And you're going to reach out as far as you can, try and touch your toes. If you can touch your toes, then try and hold onto your ankles and pull your nose towards your knees. I'm too old for that one. Good, sit down on the floor, give your legs a shake. Okay, we're going to start rolling one ankle. Make sure you use your hands for this. You want to hold your ankle, you want to hold your toes. And you're really making the foot go around a nice big circle. If you're just doing this within its own range of motion, it's not actually doing anything. So use your hands. And chain feet. Just as a good general practice rule, you should be sitting up with a really nice straight back when you do anything like this. And both legs out in front of you again, sitting up with a nice straight back, and pointing and flexing your toes. When you point and flex, you should be really pointing hard so that your heels come off the floor. When you flex again, your heels should be coming off the floor. Still the straight back, this is cheating. Straight back, really pointing and flexing hard so that your heels don't touch the floor. Okay, bring your feet in, hold your toes. One leg at a time, you're gonna start walking them forwards as far as you can. See if you can get them all the way straight. And walk in again. This time, you're gonna keep your chest on your legs. So only go as far as you can with straight legs. As far as you can, keeping your chest on your legs. You can then go here, and that's fine. But keep your chest on your legs and go as far as you can get with your chest touching. Good. And bring your feet into buttercup. Hold onto your toes. Little bounces first of all. And then using your elbows, push your knees as far down as you can, and then nose onto toes.